one, even as we are one. The purpose of Jesus giving the church or his body here on earth was that they may be united, be one, even as the Father and Jesus are one, that they may be one to the glory of God the Father. And we have been speaking concerning the glory upon the individuals as priests and as kings. And today we want to speak the glory of God upon the church as the body of Christ. And we have defined the glory as the manifestation of God's tangible and visible supernatural power. We have defined the glory as the manifestation of God's tangible and visible supernatural power. And we also say that in Psalms 19, verse 1, that the heavens declare the glory of God. And Jesus commanded us as we pray that this is how we should pray, that our Heavenly Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come here on earth, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. The will of God in heaven is that the heavens declare the glory of God. And that is the intention of God. And he said in Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 14, that as the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of God, even as the waters cover the sea. The glory of the Lord, the knowledge of the glory of the Lord shall fill the earth, even as the waters covers the sea. That is the declaration of God. In other words, no matter what is happening, what is going on, God has promised that there is a remnant in the world that will cause his glory to be filled here on earth. Although we are not seeing the glory being filled in the earth as the heavens declare the glory. There is an interesting passage in the book of Matthew chapter 27 from verse 63 to 66. You will find that this is the story of after Jesus had died and he had been buried. And now the elders and the priests went to the governor and they declared to the governor, saying, speaking of Jesus, calling him a deceiver. And this is what they said, that the deceiver said, while he was yet alive, after 3 days, I will rise again. And so the elders went to the governor that they may be given soldiers who will go and seal the tomb and keep watch, lest, this is what they said, lest the disciples may come and steal his body and declare that he has risen from the dead. And what they feared most is in verse 64. So they say that the last era shall be worse than the first. So they feared most. They knew what they did was an error. And so they say the first error, which was to crucify him, might. So they sent for the soldiers, that the soldiers may keep watch, so that the disciples might not steal him. And so the last error of the body of this deceiver, after it had been stolen, it shall be worse than the first one. The first one was to crucify him. The second error is when this deceiver is stolen from the tomb by his disciples. And so they were afraid. They were afraid that it might be stolen. And so the governor told them to go and make sure, as they are capable, to keep a seal and to keep a watch over there. And so in chapter 28 of Matthew 12 and 15, the Bible speaks of the soldiers when they went to the elders and declared to them what they saw. When this man, who they were calling the deceiver, when he resurrected, they went and they told the story. And when they told the story, the Bible says in verse 12 that they were given a large amount of money, and they were taught. The Bible says they were taught to speak a lie. And in verse 15, the Bible is telling us that the same is commonly reported among the Jews until today. Until today, the money that they were given and the lie that they went and perpetuated, that the disciples came and stole the body of this deceiver. In other words, what they were fearing happened and came to pass. And so they have been propagating that lie. They have been saying that even today, that he never rose, that he was stolen by his disciples. And Jesus has declared and proclaimed about the wisdom that they were using in Luke chapter 16, verse 18, where he said that the children of this world, they are wiser in their generation than the children of light. Why? Because they spent money to declare and propagate a lie. And the reason why they propagated a lie is that they feared the last era. They feared the last era. And we, as the church, as the body of Christ, as witnesses of this resurrection, we are the ones who have been called in this time, in this hour, to manifest the last era. They had two eras. The first era was to crucify the King of Glory, but the last was the fear of his resurrection. And we all know that he was resurrected. He is alive, and he is alive, and he is seated at the right hand of God the Father. So as the church, we are the ones to manifest the last era which they feared most. So they used money to propagate a lie, and the lie has been continuing. But God is saying in Haggai chapter 2 verse 7 that I will shake the heavens, and I will shake the heavens, and I will fill this house with the glory, says the Lord of hosts. And already they have the nations. I will shake the nations. The nations have already been shaken because of what has been going on. We all know concerning this pandemic. Already the nations has been shaken. Even as the Lord spoke, I will shake the heavens, and I will fill this house with my glory, says the Lord. So it is time for God to fill his house, which is his church, the body of Christ, with the glory that the glory Jesus said, the glory that my Father gave me, I have given unto you. The hour of God to fill his house with his glory, he has come. And Haggai chapter 2 verse 8, the Bible says, God declared, silver is mine and the gold is mine. You see, the elders and the governors and those who crucified Jesus, they used money to perpetuate a lie. And now, for God to fill his glory here on earth as it is in heaven, there has to be a use of money. Money has to be used. And now God is saying they have used a large amount of money. But I am saying that silver and gold is mine. Silver and gold belongeth heaven, they are of gold. So that declaration of the glory of God in heaven, which we are commanded to pray, that that will be done here on earth as it is in heaven, that the pavements and the streets of heaven, which are of gold, that that gold, God Jehovah has said that it is mine, be manifested here on earth. And this is what God says in John chapter 22, verse 24 and 25. He said that you shall lay gold like the dust of the earth, the gold of Ophir, like the stones of the brook, and you shall have plenty of silver. In other words, the glory that it is declared in heaven, where the streets are of gold. Now God is saying, I will use my gold and my silver to fill my glory here on earth. And he's telling the church that they shall lay down gold like the dust of the earth and plenty of silver. And in verse 9 of Haggai chapter 2, the Bible says, and the glory of this latter house, the glory of this latter house shall be greater than of the former. In other words, the manifestation of the last era, the era that the elders feared, the era that this deceiver will resurrect. The Bible is saying that the latter house, the last era, the first was to crucify him, and the first glory of the house of Solomon cannot be equated by the glory that God is going to manifest here on earth. It is going to be greater. The era that we are manifesting now of the resurrection of Jesus Christ as the King of glory is greater than the former. Why? Because today they are not dealing with Christ in a Jewish body. No, they are dealing with Christ worldwide, everywhere, in every nation, in every language, in every kind. God Jesus is being manifested in every person here on earth, that the glory of God might be filled here on earth. In 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 7, as I am about to finish, 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 7, the Bible speaks of the wisdom that we speak, not to babes or children, but the wisdom that we speak that to the mature. And he said it is the wisdom of God's mystery. It is a mystery. And this wisdom was ordained unto us, unto our glory. That's what the Bible says. The wisdom of God in a mystery, ordained unto our glory. It is the wisdom of God that will enable us to access the silver and the gold that we may manifest the last era. Hallelujah. The latter glory of the church of God. And the Bible says that if these priests knew, they would not have crucified Christ. Hallelujah. If they knew, they would not have crucified him. That the last era shall be manifested, and it shall be worse than the first. Had they known, they would not have crucified him. Hallelujah. I am through now. So we are speaking, manifesting the glory of God as the church by the wisdom of God. And we all know that in Luke chapter 19, verse 13, the Bible says, a nobleman called 10 of his servants, and he gave them 10 pounds. And with these 10 pounds, he said unto them, Go and occupy till I come. And these 10 pounds represents the book of Daniel, chapter 1, verse 20, where the Bible says, in all matters of wisdom, hallelujah, they were found to be better 10 times. Oh yes, even though that Jesus declared that the children of this world are wiser in their generation than the children of light, not now, are on earth. And the Bible says, because of the manifestation of the glory of God, the Bible says in Micah chapter 4 verse 1, that in the last days, the days that we are, that the mountain of the house of the Lord shall be lifted above all other mountains, and nations shall flow into it, and they shall say one to another, let us go into the mountain, into the house of God of Jacob, that he may teach us the mountain of the house of God, which we are, who we are, the church on a hill that cannot be hid. We cannot Jesus' name. The Lord bless you. We thank you, Father.